Good morning, everybody. I wanted to make a video before I run out to do some errands. It's an important video. I hope that people will find this online. It's something we're not thinking a lot about before we have a gastric bypass for those of us who have had it, and women of a certain age. So let me talk to you. You know how I am about the doctor and making sure they're doing everything they should be doing to check my health at my beloved Mid-Atlantic Kaiser Permanente. I basically had to beat on them to give me a bone density test. I had it about 2 weeks ago. I did that because I'd done enough reading myself to know that A, everybody's supposed to have a baseline thing. And everything I'd read said you should have it before you go through menopause or about fi the age of 50. Well, I'm 54 as of October. I have been through menopause the very same time I went through my gastric bypass loss phase. And to increase my likelihood of having osteopenia or more porous bones beyond menopause, which is extremely common for women to lose a certain degree of their bone strength past menopause, you also add in the RNY, which is a malabsorptive procedure, which means we're not absorbing calcium to the degree or anything. But there's even been studies shown that women who have RNY, like the first 4 months or something like that, and I can't, don't quote me on that because it's out there, have an X percentage of bone density loss too. So when you take post RNY months, which I've already lived through, at the same time I was going through menopause, being over 50, and Kaiser doesn't want anyone to get a baseline unless you're 64. Well, I told that lady that I had, and let's not forget, lest we forget, I was vitamin D deficient last year in February or January when they discovered it. And I had like a level of 5, which is terrible. But it was good in the summer. So somehow it whacked out. And then I took those mega doses and then it came right back up. So this is what I want to say. Please, ladies, please. Oh, so anyway, I got my results. And the note says, very cut and dried, your DEXA scan shows some bone loss. Big surprise. This is known as osteopenia or osteopenia, however you're supposed to say that. Please continue with calcium and vitamin D, 1200 milligrams daily, and do bone strengthening exercises. Thank you. Well, I wrote my doctor back and I said, do you mind giving me some concept of how much bone loss I have had? I mean, I probably won't get any answer back. I mean, I'll get an answer, but it won't be a substantive answer or something of substance that I can take to the bank and understand. I just wanted to put that out there because it's one of those things that people just don't think about. And ladies, there are many more of us having this procedure very successfully in our late 40s to mid 50s. That's actually one of the biggest groups of people that are having this procedure. I don't know if y'all realize that. I think I read that somewhere too, which really surprised me. Or it's the fastest growing or some such thing. Something out there. Anyway, God, good thing you don't quote me on anything. So I wanted to just run over a few things with you about osteopenia. Now, funny how she says do those things. Well, I already take my calcium and I take that dry D3, ladies, dry D3. Let's say it all together. Dry D3. Do not take anything the doctor gives you that's a 2, a D2. That's worthless to RNY patients. Always just get or order. If you're in my age group, I just get some. Anyway, dry D3. And talk to somebody about how much you should take. I took mega doses. Like I have a 5,000 milligram pill. And I took that once a week just to get them up. But they say actually say the best the amount of D you should get is a couple of thousand milligrams a day. So I'm using up the ones I have, and I just take one once a week just to make sure I'm good and strong, especially through the winter, which is when we get less D from the sun. Okay, and do. And calcium, which I drink and eat a lot of calcium, and I also take a calcium supplement. Strong bones and teeth. I've never had strong teeth, but I was born in 1957, so my bones, now I know. I mean, it's normative for a person of my age to start to see some loss of bone density. That's mineral density in your bone. And it does lead to osteoporosis, which is very common in women like 65 and older, and extremely, extremely, absolutely common in pear-shaped women, of which I was for the last 50 years before the last four. I'm no longer a pear, although genealogically or genetically, I'm, I guess, still a pear. Take the fat off, but I guess I would still be a pear if the fat came back on. They always have osteoporosis. They don't have the issues apples have, like heart disease and diabetes, but pear's dilemma will always be osteoporosis. So just know that if you're a pear and a woman of a certain age and going through menopause and having gastric bypass. Now, bone strengthening exercises. Lo and behold, who would have thought? Do you think that's why I go to Body Pump? That's a big reason I go to Body Pump. It's a big reason that women of my age should be focusing on things like yoga and body pump and strength training exercises and balance exercises, which is why I do when I do yoga. That's the purpose of the yoga or the whatever. Because balance is the first thing you get older, you lose your sense of balance, boom, you feel keel over, you break a hip. I mean, I don't want to get more pathetic, but that's what happens in the real world. And I'm entering that stage of my life. So, osteopenia, bones naturally become thinner as people grow older. Okay. Now, in the middle age. Now, let me tell you this something I bet you didn't know. Your bone density reaches its peak at 30 years old. Did you know that? So, your bones are their strongest and most minerally dense at age 30. And then it goes down from there. Of course, it's building up from there also. Other things you shouldn't be doing is don't drink alcohol, don't smoke, and don't drink a lot of Coca-Cola. That's what they said very specifically. My parents both broke something. My mother broke a hip, but she smoked like a chimney and she drank like a fish. And my father fell on the ice and broke a wrist once. Took a long time. It didn't ever heal very well. So it could be in my family gene pool too, but just saying. Don't let, oh, one of the other things that increase your risk is being thin. Well, gee, I just can't win, can I? I just can't win. yeah, I don't use steroids, things like that. Just wanted to bring that up, guys. Don't forget, it's all about being healthy. Goal is great. Goal is a number. Goal is a region. Goal is a place of happiness within your own life journey. Where, however you want to put it, but for me, my goal ultimately is longevity and good health. And I am addressing the fact that I have osteopenia, very common and not earth-shattering, right now, every day, as I work out, walking, they say, is the other thing, that muscle bearing, weight bearing exercise, walking. So come on, ladies, we can all be walking. I hope you guys have seen on my Facebook, and if not, I will put a link here. There's an awesome video on YouTube where a doctor is talking about isn't 23 and a half hours enough? What do you think? What do you think that's about? It's about that literally those of us or those of some who do not want to get up and move their butts, do not want to have mobility as part of your daily life that are sedentary. Like my husband, is 23 and a half hours a day not enough for you to be sedentary? Think about that. 23 and a half hours a day, you're basically sedentary. You're either sleeping, or sitting down at the job, or walking from the house into the car to drive to work. That leaves a half an hour a day. What is your excuse for 30 minutes of non-sedentary behavior out of 23 and a half hours a day? I would love to hear an excuse for that one. I'm still trying to get my husband to watch the video. I will put the link below. I gotta run. I got errands to do. It's holiday season. It's Merry Christmas time. And, you know, Mama makes the magic happen. So I love you guys, and I will see you soon. Bye.